Well, joining us tonight on Left, Right and Centre, we're joined by Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad this evening. Mr. Prasad, thank you for speaking to us on what is a very, very big day. Let me first ask you what your overall reading of this judgment is and the implications it has for the citizens of this country, because it's not something that's only limited to, say, Aadhaar. This is a judgment, sir, that could impact very, very different aspects of all our lives.
I think that is the right way to approach it. It's a great day because we had a judgment in the 50s and the 60s of 8th bench and 6th bench which held to the contrary that it is not a fundamental right. And the Supreme Court over the years rightly took the view that Indian democracy is a robust democracy, therefore right to privacy must be held to be a part of fundamental right. What is more important, which Mr. Dattar just, I heard him on your channel, the Supreme Court has also held that though it is a fundamental right, flows from Article 21 and other fundamental rights, it is not an absolute right. It is subject to reasonable restrictions as other fundamental rights are. And the second is, the factual implications is required to be adjudicated from case to case basis. Therefore, a very robust mechanism of privacy being elevated to the concept of a fundamental right has been laid down. Nidhi, I would like to clarify one thing, because your initial anchor who was giving a report commented about me that I am taking a contrary position. It is not. The argument of the Attorney General has been noted in the Supreme Court itself at page 193, where he has stated it is not an independent fundamental right, but part of right to life and other subspaces with reasonable restrictions. And Mr. Arun Jaitley, Finance Minister, on 16th of March 2016, while moving the Aadhaar Act in Raj Sabha, categorically stated that we do recognize privacy as a fundamental right, flowing from Article 21. It is also subject to reasonable restrictions.
But Mr. Prasad, with respect, that is not the position the government actually took in court. And I quote to you what Mr. Venugopal said in the Supreme Court, and which the court actually struck down with a specific reference to this. He said, a vague and amorphous right can't be held as a fundamental right. The right to privacy argument is elitist. This was the government's position in the court. You're right about what Mr. Arun Jaitley said, but that's not the position he took in court.
I would only tell you, Nidhi, that kindly read page 193 of the judgment. I'm having a copy of the judgment, where all the arguments of Mr. Venugopal has been quoted. What Mr. Venugopal has argued, as to what the petitioners are arguing, that right to privacy is a stand-alone fundamental right. Okay. He said, no, it is not a stand-alone. It flows from the existing fundamental right, a part of right to life with dignity and other fundamental rights. And I would, great respect to you, say that that argument has been upheld. Let me put it differently. Let us forget about the perception. Now to the judgment, it is binding. Okay? And let me elevate this debate to a different level.
Mr. Prasad,
now privacy has been read as ingrained.
I just want to ask you, sir, sorry to interrupt.
All right, go ahead.
But the previous Attorney General, before Mr. Venugopal, also took a position in the Supreme Court that right to privacy is not a fundamental right. He did it once in 2015, where he said that it's not a fundamental right, it can't be invoked to scrap Aadhaar, and that the Constitution makers did not intend to make privacy a fundamental right. Mr. Rohatgi argued in May of this year that one cannot have an absolute right over his or her body. Mr. Rohatgi, who is coming on the program later today, has reiterated that. He feels that the court has overstepped, that it is a case of judicial overreach, what has happened today. Mr. Prasad, how can you say that the government took a position that right to privacy is a fundamental right, sir?
First of all, you don't pitch me against my former Attorney General. That is not fair. Okay? He said it at the stage of an interlocutory applications about interim orders. And he did a good job. Okay? Nidhi, your viewers need to know that we have saved 57,000 crores of the poor through DBT using Aadhaar and mobile and Jandan account, which used to be pocketed by middlemen or fictitious claimants. Poor are happy, but that is beside the point. What is important is the firm articulation of the view was given by Mr. Arun Jaitley, the Finance Minister, when a specific query was asked of him as to what is the stand of the government as far as right to privacy is concerned.
But that was not
and what
in
he
court.
Said on 16th of
but
March,
that was not
I have
court.
Articulated.
That was not in Just court. In court, the government took
on,
a different
in
position.
In court, Nidhi, please, I just told you what Mr. Venugopal argued, read at page 193. It was very clearly stated, we don't agree with the view that it is an absolute right, independent fundamental right. But this right is ingrained in the existing fundamental rights, which we respect and subject to the reasonable restriction it is. But today, let us not quibble about the argument. Today, there is a judgment. And as far as Aadhaar is concerned, Aadhaar is to be adjudicated separately. But our view is very clear that we have got a law sanctioning a legislative approval to Aadhaar with due regard to privacy, section 26 to section 33. And I, as an IT minister of India, an Indian law minister, cannot disclose my own biometrics or iris to anyone for unauthorized use. Today the UN and the World Bank all are appreciating this great delivery.
Well, as you
we'll
said,
argue ourselves in the
I know,
court.
And as you
That's
said,
one thing
it's something that the court has to look at separately.
Yes.
So the Aadhaar issue is something that will be watched closely. Do you think also, Mr. Prasad, though, that some of the other things that the court said today could actually give a cue to Parliament to perhaps legislate, for instance, on Section 377? The judges were very unequivocal in what they felt on the issue of homosexuality, saying discrimination based on sexual orientation is offensive to the dignity of an individual. There should be equal protection of every individual without discrimination, that sexual orientation is an essential component of identity. Is this a very clear message from the top court today that Parliament could actually take a cue from and maybe initiate a change on that law?
I think that aspect requires to be examined. I share with you that some of the judges have been very firm, but not all the judges. Okay? Therefore, to read it as in, with due regard to the rights of lesbian and gay, they have been agitating and they may have a point also. But since you are reading it in today's judgment as a part of a dictum, that matters, I'm afraid, requires some examination. There are certain other pending issues and the Parliament will have to take an independent call regardless of this judgment. They have been agitating. But today is not the occasion for me to speak authoritatively as to what is required to be done, because that matter requires some examination.
There is another important comment made, another important observation made, where the judgment talks about life being precious in itself, that the duty of the state is to safeguard the ability of people to take decisions, the autonomy of the individual, and not to dictate those decisions. What do you think of that, Mr. Prasad, at a time when people have been unhappy about, being told what they should eat, whether beef should be eaten or not eaten, whether homes should be raided by the police over whether beef is stored in a fridge and so on. These seem to be very strong words coming from the Supreme Court today.
First of all, since you have asked me this question, Nidhi, let me make it very clear as a senior minister of this government, we are not in the business of determining the food habit of Indians. We celebrate the plurality and diversity of India. Yes, there are a view in the constitution itself, a big majority of people respect, worship cows. Others have the different taste. And that diversity needs to be explained and also understood. The second part is concerned, yes, we are a part of the robust democracy. And since I'm on NDTV today, I need to say it with some degree of pride that this government is led by Narendra Modi, Sushma Swaraj, Rajnath Singh, Arun Jaitley, Ravi Shankar Prasad, who have fought in the emergency for three freedom, individual freedom, media freedom, and independence of judiciary. And don't forget this, Nidhi, I allow me to say that there was an argument by the then Attorney General of the Congress government that if a person is killed in emergency, he has no remedy. That was upheld in ADM Jabalpur.
And that's why the Congress
That is also the record of the fight of civil liberty.
That's why the Congress that's why the Congress was voted out.
What is important today?
But Mr. Prasad, let me ask you a final question, sir.
You are right today.
I just want to ask you a final question on Aadhaar. And of course, as we said, the court is looking at that matter. How would you address the concerns, though, that people have about privacy issues and Aadhaar? It is still a big concern. Many people and data has been compromised in the past. It has been compromised at a large level. It's also been contained. But how would you address those concerns today?
First of all, no data has been pilfered on a large measure. Some people tried to, they have been arrested, police action has been done because of tough law in the Aadhaar law, number one. Number two, Nidhi, I would welcome to have an independent debate with you on Aadhaar. Let me assure the countrymen, the Aadhaar law is safe, secure, and privacy has been given due regard. And you know, we can only release data for national security, and that too approved by a joint secretary decision based upon cogent ground, affirmed by a committee of cabinet secretary, IT secretary and law secretary, what Supreme Court has said in the telephone tapping case. Therefore, and it is a part of good governance. But let me come to the larger issue. And Nidhi, NDTV is watched in many parts of the world. Therefore, it is important for me to convey that. India is emerging as a big digital power. Today, India's digital story of digital India is being celebrated world over. Many countries are talking about this great success of digital inclusion of the poor and marginalized. What is important for us is to balance the right of the people of privacy and the availability of data. And therefore, we have constituted a committee headed by Justice Krishna, a very eminent retired of Supreme Court, to ensure a proper data safety and security. But let us not do anything which seeks to compromise the emergence of India's digital power, innovation, and other startup movement today, which is becoming a great celebration and success story of India.
All right.
That is very important to be conveyed.
All right, Mr. Prasad, let's see what the Supreme Court actually does say on the Aadhaar.